Tyga has given his best wishes to Blac Chyna and Rob Kardashian for their engagement. Mm-hmm. He went on Twitter and said, "It makes me happy to see the mother of my son happy. My only concern in this situation is my son. I want him in happy environments. Everybody deserves to be happy. What someone does for their happiness is not my concern as long as it's not interfering with my happiness."
Why wouldn't the son be happy, though? I mean, the son is in the same family that you're in, Tyga.
He's saying he's happy for him as long as he's happy. She's happy. Okay. Now he said, "Cherish your own blessings and stop hating mine when you've been blessed how I've been, and create someone you love unconditionally. You'll understand how I feel. You'll want to protect that blessing. Only an evil heart would direct negativity at a child and make fun of him for being in a situation that is out of his control. He's innocent in this, and I want him to feel as much love as possible."
Oh, that's because people was clowning Tyga, saying Tyga is like, what is he, an uncle?
He's an uncle to his son.
Oh. Yeah, that's weird.
That makes no sense to me. But Tyga had no choice but to put on a happy face. What are you going to do? Come out and be like, "Oh, I'm mad my baby mama got with a new dude." No, he should be happy.
And then if he gets married to Kylie, then Blac Chyna will be, what she would be.
I know plenty of baby fathers out there that are hoping their baby mamas find a man. So drop one of Clues bombs for Blac Chyna. She found a man. Good job, Rob. You helping brothers out here in these streets, keeping hope alive.
Now, Rob also got Blac Chyna a 7-carat round brilliant cut diamond, and he got it from Ben Baller. We had Ben Baller up here before in L.A.
Rob got that much money?
Well, he spent $325,000, allegedly, on this ring. So
Jeez. I ain't spending that much money on something I may have to take back now.
Well, if he has to take it back, I think he gets to keep it, right?
It depends on a few things now. If they don't get married, yes, he should be able to get the ring back. The only time that you have to give the ring up, and this is why they say it's not the best idea to propose on a holiday, is if it's a gift. Like it's Valentine's Day, it's Christmas, it's someone's birthday. Then it's considered a gift and they get to keep it.
Yeah, he ain't got to worry about that.
And Blac Chyna, don't buy Rob a ring just yet. Wait till he gets down to the weight he wants to be at, because right now he's still got them fat ass fingers. So the ring you get him when you get his size, it ain't going to fit once he
does
loses
look
that
a lot better, though, you know. And Rob Kardashian, if he's you want to know how he proposed, well, he allegedly set the mood. He covered the room in her house where he proposed with hundreds of rose petals. They said more than 500 roses were used for that.
He had chocolate too, but he ate it before.
Then he put enough candles in the room, and then when Blac Chyna and her mom walked into the room, he got down on bended knee and asked a question, and she responded, "Of course, baby, you know I love you."
Mom was probably right there. Yes, we say yes. Yes.
Mm-mm-mm. Let's go. All right. Now, shout out to Mimi from Love & Hip Hop Atlanta. Apparently, she's in a relationship now, and her relationship is with a new girlfriend named Chris. Here is what she said on the show.
How long has this been?
Like a year or some change. Can you believe we've been together this long?
I can believe it. Can you believe it?
Yes, because you're gay for Chris.
Yeah, I know. I bagged you. I have had experiences with women before, but Chris is the first woman that I have ever had a relationship with.
God bless Mimi. She's so lost.
Now, Stevie J thinks that Mimi's only deciding to be a lesbian for a good storyline.
Duh.
Not threatening legal action yet, but he also doesn't want his 6-year-old daughter being raised by two women, so he's not cool with it.
That's a damn shame. Now, that's what you call selling your soul for TV.
Now, I'm going to keep it real. I know a couple of people who are friends with Mimi, and they said she actually has been dating Chris for a while, and she wasn't going to bring her on the show at first. But then she changed her mind.
But she needed that check.
Supposedly, this is a real, real relationship.
The shower rod storyline did what it did. The Stevie J Jocelyn storyline is played out.
She got to stay on TV,
bro. Now I'm going to go jump and start eating some vagina to be on TV.
Well, she been eating vagina, but now she got to stay on TV, bro.
Now she has an actual girlfriend.
Mm-hmm.
All right, well, that is your rumor report. I'm Angela.